My name is Laura Robson, and I'm a professor in the history department here at PSU. I started off as a historian who was looking at the genesis of what we call minorities in the Middle East. So thinking about religious minorities, ethnic minorities, linguistic minorities, how they came to be thought of as groups separate from some kind of majority. So my first book project was about Christians, Arab Christians in Palestine during the interwar period and how they came to constitute a kind of specific sort of political group as well as a religious community. But since then, I have also broadened out my scope to think about issues of displacement and refugeedom in particular. So some of my other projects have looked at how nation states and international organizations move people around for their own purposes. And of course, in some ways that connects with the idea of minorities because those populations are most likely to be the ones who are displaced. I'm also working on a new project that is a history of the idea of resettling refugees in so-called empty territory across the globe. And that's an idea that originates first in the 1920s and 1930s and was kind of a moving principle of the League of Nations policy in the Middle East during that period, but then became a kind of basic principle of European and American refugee resettlement policy during and after the Second World War. Issues surrounding the Middle East have been represented in very ahistorical ways in the public sphere. So when we think about the kind of violence, that's kind of sectarianism that we see in the Middle East today, we have very little understanding of the ways in which external powers have made those conditions, have created those conditions for their own purposes. And so there's a sense, I think, of correction that drives a lot of my work, that I want people to understand that there are specific historical reasons for the emergence of the kind of state failures and the kind of political violence that we've seen, you know, come to be such a marked characteristic of the 20th century Middle East, and that we can trace a lot of those histories back, particularly to the extremely brutal forms of colonial rule that Europe enacted in the 20th century Middle East and that have been continued in many ways by American policies after 1945. My name is Laura Robson, and through my work, I'm trying to make people understand the origins of the kinds of global inequities that we see today and perhaps to think about some alternatives to those forms of organization.